हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सॉल्व एक्सरसाइज 1.3। ओके, सो लेट्स स्टार्ट। सो द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज कमिंग एज राइट द फॉलोइंग इन डेसिमल फॉर्म एंड से व्हाट काइंड ऑफ डेसिमल एक्सपांशन ईच हैज। वी नो वी हैव टू टाइप्स ऑफ डेसिमल एक्सपांशन। इट शुड बी टर्मिनेटिंग, राइट? इट वॉज कन्वर्टेड बाय 1/4। We have converted 1 by 4 to 0.25 and it is terminating because all the numbers after decimal point are terminating. So there is no repeating digit and there are not infinite numbers. So it will be a terminating number. And let's suppose 1 by 3 is converted into 0.3333 and so on. That is, we can write it as 0.3 bar. So it is repeating number because after decimal point numbers are repeating. Mainly two types of decimal form we have. It is terminating. First type is terminating. Second is non-terminating, that we have seen in our previous class. Okay. So let's start with the first solution first. Here the first question is 36 upon 100. You have two methods. If you know the basics how to adjust the 10 to the powers from numerator or denominator to a number or in a fraction, it will be very easy. Otherwise, some students will end up doing this for a basic question. As 36 is less than 100, you will take 0 point and will take, this will be 36. You know, I believe all of you know how to divide. After taking decimal, you will take 0. Now, what you will do? 100 threes are 300. Then subtract. Again 60. Now, after decimal, in each step, you can take 10. And what it will be? 100 sixes are 600. So, it will be 600. As we got remainder 0, that means it is terminating decimal. For any fraction, if you start solving, dividing numerator by denominator by your division method, and as soon as you get remainder as 0, that means that number, that is that rational number, is terminating number, or its decimal expansion will be terminating. So it is 0.36. And the second method, which is basic, let's revise. For example, there is a number 2, 3, 4. If decimal is not there, that means the decimal point is at the rightmost, after the rightmost number here, and after decimal you can put any number of zeros. It will not create any disturbance in your number. Now, as this point is here, and if I want to divide it by 100, so what you have to do, just count how many number of zeros are there on 1. Here we can see 2 number of zeros are there. That means we have to switch or shift my decimal point to the left hand side by 2 digits. How many zeros are there? By that number you have to switch your decimal point to the left. So here 2 is there, 1 and 2 here. So the answer will be 2.34. Okay, let's take second example. For example, 1267.894 is there, and you want to divide it by 1000. So what I just said, you have to first count how many zeros are there on 1. Here 3 zeros are there, that means we have to shift our decimal point to the left hand side by 3 digits. Okay, so just shift. So the answer will be, shift it 1, 2 and 3. So here before 2, that is 0.267894 will be my answer, and we can't write 0.2, so you should precede it by a 0. So it will look like 0.267894. While reading, you can read it as 0.267. That means 0. Okay. as you can see, it is also terminated. So this expansion or this fraction given as 234 divided by 100 is a terminating decimal after conversion. Okay. I believe all of you got this. Now, as we are dividing by 100 or by the tens power. Tens power means 10 to the power 1 will be 10, 10 to the power 2 will be 100, 10 to the power 3 will be 1000 and so on. If we are dividing by tens power, we have to shift our decimal to the left hand side by the number of zeros. Okay. And if it is in multiplication, what you will do? If it is in multiplication, for example, the question is 3.467 into 10. If the tens power is in multiplication, as obvious, you have to reverse. In division, we have shifted to the left. That means in multiplication, we have to shift to the right hand side. So here you have to shift onto the right hand side by the number of zeros. First count, number of zeros are there, only one. So only by only one digit you have to shift your decimal to the right hand side. So it will be after 4 only. So its answer will be 34.67. Getting it? Let's take second example. Let's suppose there are 3, 4, 5, 7, 9. Okay. Now here. And you have to multiply it by 10 to the power 5. That means we have 10 to the power 5 means 5 zeros are there. It can be written in this form or it can be written in this form. As we know that if 10 to the power 5 is there, that means if we expand it, 1 will be succeeded by 5 number of zeros. So here we previously know. Already here 5 number of zeros will be there. That means we have to shift our decimal point to the right hand side by 5 digits. So how to? You can do here 1, 2, 3. But after 3? After 3. So for that you should know if the number is like this. And if there is a decimal point and some numbers are there at the So what I said, 34.579 is number is there. You can precede at the last or you can append at the last as many zeros as you want. It will not change the definition of the number. That is the value of the number. Okay. So here there are zeros present after this number. Okay. Like this. Let me erase this. Now, as you want to switch your or shift your decimal point to the right hand side by 5 digits to adjust this 10 to the power 5, what we can do? Just shift it 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So the number will become 3, 4, 5, 7, 9, 0, 0, 0.0, 0, 0, 0. As obvious, as I just said, after decimal point zeros are there, there is no need to write the zeros. If only zeros are there, it should not be like 05067 and all. Otherwise, you can write only 5 if 5 is there. In our case, we don't have this. So the final answer will be 3457900. Okay, it is not a decimal, as obvious. This was a question only to express you how to adjust the decimal. So just remember, instead of try to remembering both these concepts, division and multiplication, you can memorize any one. So I recommend you to memorize this division. If you want to divide a number by tens power, that means you have to switch or shift your decimal point to the left hand side. and converse of it you have to do in multiplication. In division we are shifting to left hand side, in multiplication we are shifting to right hand side. Don't confuse in this. Okay, now coming to the question. Here 36 upon 100 you can directly write 0.36 by the given concept that I have revised you. And after looking to this number, you can say it is a terminating decimal. So just write it is terminating. Decimal. Always after converting decimal in this question, you have to write it is terminating decimal or repeating decimal or terminating non-terminating non-repeating decimal. Whichever the format is. Okay, now coming to the second one, that is 1 by 11. So let's start with 1 by 11. 1 upon 11. Here, 10th power is not there. That means we have to directly divide it as it is. We have to divide 1 by 11. So what I can get? L first, as 1 is less than 11, we have to give by 0. 11 0 is 11, 11 0 is 0. Now after getting 1, again put a point and you can take a 0. Again this is, the number is less than 11, so I will give by 0. Now you can take again 1 0. Now here 100 is greater than 11, that's why we can give. So 11 9s are 99. Got it? Again 1. Here you can see the remainder, that 1 we got is started repeating. To cross verify, solve it again. Again, you have to give, you can take 1 0. Right? In every step, you can take 1 0. Now, as 10 is less than 100, 11 given by 0, again you will get 10. Now in this step you will get, here you can see we got 10, here 10, first we got 1, here we got 1, right? Now 0 will come, again 11 9s are 99, subtraction will be 1, again remainder is 1. So same process will go on because numbers are repeating, that is that remainders are repeating. So this number here you can see in quotient, what you will get? 0.09090909 and so on. If you start working on it continuously, that means this 09 is recurring. So after converting 1 by 11, we can write 0.09 bar because 09 is repeating. Okay, if someone asks you what is the significance of it, significance means what is the meaning of it, that means 09 is repeating continuously, it is not terminating. Okay, so this decimal is, it is non recurring, you can write recurring decimal or you can write repeating decimal. Okay, this was our second sub question of question number 1. Now again in third one, 4 and 1 8 is there, how to convert it? Third one, 4 and 1 8, it's mean, what does it mean? It is 4 and 1 by 8, that is 4 plus 1 by 8. Now we know how to add two numbers if one is in fraction and other is in integer type. So here 4 into 8 plus 1 upon 8, 4 8 is a Let me write this. Okay. 32 plus 1 upon 8. So it will be 33 upon 8. That means I have to divide 33 by 8 to get its decimal expansion. So let's start. Divide 33 by 8. What you will get? Eight fours are 32. You will get 1, right? Again, you took a decimal, so it will be 0 at the end of 1. 8 ones are 8. 2 will be there. Again, 0. 8 twos are 16. It will be 4. Again, 1 0 will come. 8 fives are 40. That means the remainder is 0. And as soon as you see the remainder is 0, that means it is terminating decimal. So its expansion will be 4.125. So its decimal representation will be 4 and 1/8. Decimal representation will be 4.125. You can do it directly also here. 1 by 8 is 0.2125. Just add it with 4, you will get 4.125. Just for explanation, I have written this. Here you can see it is terminating. Just write it is terminating. Decimal, right? Now the next question. Fourth one, 3 by 13. Fourth one. Just divide 3 by 13. Decimal will come. Okay, after decimal you have taken this 0. This is the basic everyone should know. Now 13 twos are 26. It will be 4. Again 0 will come. Now 13 threes are 39. Again remainder 1. Again 0. So you have to give first by 0 because 10 is less than 13. Now again 0 will come. Now divide 100 by 13. What you will get? By which number you can divide? Right, 13 sevens are 91. So what you will get? 13 sevens are 91. Remainder is 9. Okay. Now again 0 will be there. Now 13 sixes are 78. Again 12 will be remainder. Again 0 will come. Okay. So now the 13 eights are 13 nines are will use, which is 117. Again you got remainder 3. Now 0 will be there. Again 13 twos are. Here you can see remainder start repeating. Here we got 30. Here also we got 30. That means whenever the remainder started repeating, you have to stop. As 3 came, I have stopped. That means after this number, this will be repeated. Again, this term 30 will become, you have to divide it by 2. Sorry. Right, 13 twos are 26, again 4, then again 13 threes are 39, and so on. So for this number 13 by 13, what you will get? .230769 bar. Always remember, as soon as the remainder repeated, you have to stop. That means all this quotient will be repeating. All the numbers after decimal point will be repeating. That is recurring number. As you can see, it is non-terminating. and it is repeating number. Just write it is recurring number or repeating number. Okay. Next one. 2 by 11. I'll put it to Humber for you. 2 by 11. Okay. Now this 329 by 400. It is very simple. 329. Last question we are getting. Doing 329 by 400. If such type of numbers are there, we know how to adjust the tens power. 100. If 100 is there, we can directly adjust. But here 400 is there. So what do we have to do? I'll write 4 into 100. Directly divide this 329 by 4 and then adjust your decimal number, this 100. Okay. So let's start. Divide your 329 by 4. 4 8 is 32. 0. 9 will come. 4 2 is 8. 1. Then you will take decimal. 4 2 is 8. 2 will be there. Again 0. 4 5 is 20. That means it's this answer. This answer will be my 82.25 divided by 100. Now we know how to adjust. If in division we have to count the number of zeros and shift the decimal. Here two numbers of zeros are there. That means two by two digits we have to shift. So what I will get? 0.8225. So decimal conversion of 329 by 400 will be 0.8225. As we can see, it is a terminating decimal. So it is terminating decimal number. Okay. Now in second question, what you can see, they are asking you to find 2 by 7, 3 by 7, 4 by 7 without actually doing the long division, where 1 by 7 is given. It is very simple. In solution, I will solve the first question, that is 2 by 7. I can write 2 by 7 as 2 into 1 by 7, right? So, what is the value of 1 by 7? It is given as 0.1428. 5 7 bar. Now here you just need to multiply this number by 2 and keep the bar sign as it is. How to? Let me explain. 1 4 2 8 5 7. Here the bar is there. That means this number will be repeated. So there is no need to multiply the other numbers. We will directly multiply these numbers and keep the bar as it is on the given number of digits. So 2 7 is 14, carry 1. 2 5 is 10 plus 1, carry 1. 2 8 is 16 plus 1, 17, carry 1. 2 2 is 4 plus 1, 5. 2 4 is 8. 2 1 is 2. And I have to keep my bar on this number. Right? So the answer for this is, after multiplying 2 into this number, the answer will be 0.285714 bar. Same method will be followed to find 3 by 7. You just need to multiply this number by 3 instead of 2. For finding 4 by 7, multiply by 4 and so on. Very simple question, right? Now moving towards question number 3. Now coming to the question number 3, express the following in the form of P by Q, where P and Q are the integers. We have seen this, how to convert a given decimal rational number into P by Q form. What was the 3 steps? Let's quickly solve any number. This is very simple. We will solve this. First step is take X as the given number. Okay. Now multiply both side by 10 to the power m, where m is number of repeating digits. Here you can see how many number of digits, repeating digits are there. Only one digit is repeating, that is 7. That means m value will be 1. So we have to multiply by 10 to the power 1, that means by 10 on both sides. So what I will write, multiply both side by 10. What I will get? 10x 4.7 bar. This was our second step. Now what we have seen in third step? We have to subtract your x value, that is this value, x value, from the number which we obtained in second step. Okay, so I'll write 4.777 and so on. We have to subtract this number from this number, this r given number, that is 0.4.4777, right? Here you can observe all 7 will be cancelled after subtraction from the right hand side. Only this 7 minus 4 will be 3, 4 minus 0 will be 4. So the answer is 4.3 after subtraction. So just write this number 4.3 plus our given number. What was our given number? It is 0.47 bar. Here you can observe we have just made the adjustment. Okay, here I have subtracted my value, given value from this. That means this addition will be the same question. Okay. So this step was only to minimize the burden on our head, how to split it into x plus some given number. This step is not written in your book, but we have made it for our sake of simplicity. Now here you can observe 4.3 plus this is your value x that we have assumed. So what I have got? X. Shift this x to the left hand side. What I will get? 10x minus x equals to 4.3. This will be my 9x equals to 4.3. You can write your 4.3 as 4 by 10, right? Very simple. We have just seen reverse, we have seen, so you can also reverse it. Now send your 9 to the right hand side. What I will get? X equals to 43 upon 9 into 10, 90. Very simple, x equals to 43 by 90. Okay, so in this way we have converted our 0.437 bar as 43 by 90, that is in the form of p upon q. Here you can see p is your integer, q is also your integer. By the same way, you have to convert your second and third. If any problem is there, do comment, I'll try to solve it. Here in fourth question, let us convert or try to convert it in the form of p by q. What will happen, we'll see. What was our first step? We have to assume let x equals to the given number, that is point, it as it is 999, I'll put 99 bar. Okay, now we have to multiply. The second step is multiply the number on both sides by 10 to the power m, where m is number of repeating digits. How many digits are repeating here? Only one. That means value of m is 1. So we have to multiply by 10 to the power 1, that is 10. So multiply both side by 10. What you will get? 10x equals to, as this was 0.99, we will get 9.9 bar, that is 9.999. okay, next, what was this third step? What we are doing? We are subtracting the number so obtained in second step by our given number. What I will get? 9, because these numbers will be cancelled out. That means I can write the given number as 9 plus our given number, that is 0.999. This was very easy, but you have to follow the algorithm or the number of steps which we have given. So it will not create any confusion in your mind how to solve different type of questions. Here this was x, I can write 9 plus x. So that means shift your x to the left hand side, 10x minus x will be 9x equals to 9. 9, 9 will get cancelled. So what we have, x equals to 1. That means we have converted 0.99 as 1. How it is possible? It is possible because this 0.999 is infinitely close to 1. 0.9 bar is, here 9 is going to the infinite times. So it is very approximately equal to 1. That's why 0.9 bar can be written as 1. Approximately. Very small differences in between them. And that small difference you cannot calculate. So mathematically 0.9 bar is considered as 1. So do remember this thing. That's why this question makes sense solving. 0.9 bar is equals to 1.